Hey guys, today I'm teaching quarter in this Philodendron Pedatum variegated. Okay, so a couple of weeks ago, I purchased this Philodendron Pedatum variegated from a local plant sale. I would say that I got a peer pressure into purchasing this plant. And to be honest, I'm terrified to build this plant. So I will say myself, well, I want to attempt to teach quarter in this plant. That way I can hopefully keep this plant alive. For me, it's actually easier to keep plants alive in tissue quarter than outside of tissue quarter like this. So, and also because I can make someone a little bit more money back because it was a little expensive. It was quite an expensive plant. So let's get it started. The first thing I'm going to do is to make my sterilizing solution. And I'm going to use a small test tube because I'm going to take like a small cutting. So I'm going to take some distilled water. I want to take 9 milliliters of distilled water. There we go. So I have 9 milliliters of distilled water. Next, I'm going to take use a commercial bleach. This is just Clorox bleach you can get from the grocery store. And I'm going to take my other micropipette and I'm going to add 1 milliliter of bleach. There we go. Next, I'm going to add a surfactant. This is a polysorbent 20. You can also use like something like 2020 or a dish detergent if you don't have anything like this. It's pretty much it. Only what the surfactant does is to make the bleach have a better contact with the surface of the plant, so it has a better sterilizing solution. So I just want to check this for a moment, a couple times. There's a back here. And now I'm ready to take the cutting for my plant. So let me show you here. With tissue quarter, in theory, you should be able to take any part of the plant and regenerate new ones. Unfortunately, that's in theory, and in practice, it's a lot more difficult. So I cannot take use a part of the leaf. I actually had to take a node. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this node right here. So this is the new leaf coming up, and there's one node, and there is two nodes, and you can see this tiny little right here, that's another node that is coming up. So what I'm going to do is I just want to cut it right here. This is the new leaf, which is a really nice leaf. Unfortunately, I will have to sacrifice it. I'm going to cut it. I'm going to cut this part, and this is going to be my cut. Well, I want to leave the rest of the plant alone. I don't want to take as that much plant material. I think that should be enough for me to place this plant in tissue quarter. So let me do it. Okay, so I have my sterile scalpel. And this is usually a lot easier to deal with scissors. Well, I lost my scissors, so I just want to deal with a scalpel. And I just want to cut right here. You can see this notes. So I want to take 2 notes. There we go. So this is my node, and this is the leaf. So this is the newest leaf, and I want to cut it. I don't need this part. So I'm just going to clean it up a little more. I'm going want to cut it, just being careful not to damage the apical meristem. There we go. And this leaf hasn't opened yet, which is a good thing, because if this will be open by now, it will be a lot more difficult to sterilize. So this is the perfect moment for me to place this plant in tissue culture. Other than that, my other apical meristem is just right here, and the other one will be kind of inside of the wrap, inside this this plant. So I will do the next. Into a open my test tube, and I want to place my plant in. So there we go. And now what I want to do is I want to give it between 10 and 15 minutes. So I want to set my timer, and then I'll be right back when this is ready. Just been 15 minutes since I placed a cutting in the bleach, and you can tell that the plant is turning color. Now it's a lighter green. It's getting more like a whitish color. And just by experience on doing tissue culture for so many years now, I will say I want to give this a couple more minutes. I just want to make sure it's completely sterile before I take it out of the bleach. This is 19 minutes in bleach, almost 20 minutes in bleach. I want to take it out now. You ask me how can I determine the amount of time that I give to my plants? It's just mostly by experience, just by kind of looking at the plants. Something that you just kind of experience. And a lot of people say that, or tell me that, well, I have followed the protocol. It says you give it 10 or 15 minutes or 20 minutes, and the plant got contaminated. Well, you don't follow the protocol. Is just kind of a base just to determine how much time just to get it started. Well, you may need to use a different thing. So now I'm going to add some sterile water. This is the same water that I used last when I did the cactus. So it will still be sterile. This one too. Put some water in here. And I'm going to rinse it for like 5 minutes just so I can remove all the bleach from the plant. But yeah, use the protocol is use a base. Use to follow. You don't, because the plant that whatever person was wrote the protocol, it's not the same plant you're working with. Even if it's the same plant species, I mean, it's a different plant. This is like, this is my plant, and you got your own plant. They're growing in different conditions. So the time is going to be, it may not be the same. Whatever it works for me, it may not work for you. So you have to do your own experiments. And like I say, just come for experience where I can see how much time the plant is in, or I can see when the plant, where the bleach is pretty much done sterilizing the tissue. So I can just take the plants out of the bleach. All right, so now I'm going to do a second rinse. So again, I just went to carry all this water. This will be water. And I'll be back in 5 minutes. So this is my third and final rinse. I want to get everything ready to do my cuts. It's time to take the plant out of my test tube so I can cut it. So I just want to open it here with the water as well. It's fine. I want to grab my sterile forceps and a sterile scalpel. So grab it here. And it's not to cut. So I want to cut the very end. because it has been sterilized today, so I don't need it. I'm just going to kind of clean this up a little more. So I'm just going to go all around. And now I just want to place it in my media. There we go, just like that. Very easy. What I'm going to do is that I want to be posting updates on TikTok, Instagram. So make sure to follow us on Facebook, Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok. So make sure to follow us on all those accounts. I'm going to be posting updates on this. If it gets contaminated, I want to do a sterilization, and I will. I want to do a sterilization, and maybe depending on how contaminated it is, I may have to do some shoot apical meristem. So make sure to stay in tune for that. As for now, I just want to wrap this up, put a name on it, and that'll be everything. So I hope you have enjoyed. Let me know what plan you want me to work next. And also, we have the tissue culture masterclass online. It's going to be an online version this time. So it's going to be on July 29 and 30. It's going to be online. So make sure to check the link down below to set your spot. So hope you have enjoyed, and then I'll see you next week.
Thanks for watching the video. If you are enjoying these tissue culture videos, make sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you are interested on conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantsafetechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use code FP10 for 10% off on your first purchase.